Why does sometimes people's butt cracks tickle or itch? The potential dangers of an itchy butt crack. Do tattoos cause cancer? And surprisingly, this one thing may just help you live longer. Today, we're diving into some of the most embarrassing and thought-provoking medical questions on the internet. Brace yourselves, no question is off limits. This might get a little weird. All right, let's dive right in. First question, what's the difference between VD, STD, and STI?
We get you tested. For STDs, that's not an issue.
Well, that's actually a really good question. VD stands for venereal disease. STD stands for sexually transmitted disease, and STI stands for sexually transmitted infection. Basically, they all kind of mean the same thing. VD is not used anymore, and STD and STI are kind of used interchangeably, except STI is the more approved term to use, and it has the broadest catchment of all these sexually transmitted infections. Does having a good social circle help people live longer? My grandma lives in a remote village, and we don't visit her that often. So yes, actually having a good social circle has actually been shown to help with longevity and having a good life and support structure. And they've actually done studies in the Journal of Epidemiology, and they actually have evidence to show that good social networks help you live longer. There are other things that you can do to help you live longer as well. Good diet, good lifestyle, good activity, and again, get in a good social network of individuals. Why does sometimes people's butt cracks tickle or itch?
I'd like to ask you a few questions.
There's a multitude of reasons why that would actually happen. It's like infections, dermatitis, so skin inflammation, fungal infections, but there's also something called pinworms, which are little worms that can actually tickle the little hole and people end up itching. And the reason why it continues to spread is you itch it, you get the larvae or the worms under your skin, accidentally touch something else, somebody accidentally eats that and starts the cycle. It's something called ass-to-mouth transmission, and it is quite common in the medical world. Hey, Dr. Wagner, why is asthma triggered by smell sometimes? Seems to be stuff like deodorant, Lysol, smoke, perfume, and other strong smells.
Ooh, it's a formidable scent. It stings the nostrils.
What is asthma for all the individuals that might not know? It is a chronic lung disease, which basically has to do with inflammation of your airway as well as the spasming of your muscles around your airway, which also tighten it. And so when you get an ear tint into that area, hence a noxious smell or something in the air, it can cause irritation leading to a cascade of inflammation within the lungs themselves or the airway, leading to coughing as well as increased mucus production. So it can trigger asthma and make it difficult to breathe. What even are tonsils and why do so many people get them removed?
Well, there's no doubt about it. Those tonsils need to come out.
So your tonsils are two lymphoid tissues that are in the back of your throat that help you with your immune system. They help fight infections. Some individuals get a lot of recurrent infections in their tonsils where they have sleep apnea because their tonsils are so big, occluding their airway, or you get something called a peritonsillar abscess. So a lot of different other things that can happen and cause problems, and that is the main reason why you would get something called a tonsillectomy. Typically, when people get their tonsils removed, they're usually at a young age, and they also get their adenoids removed as well, and they have a similar role in our bodies. I've been smoking marijuana for a while and noticed that it has completely changed my sleep. Why is this? So marijuana, cannabis use, THC can affect your sleep. It can affect the stage of sleep having to do with restorative sleep and dreaming, aka REM sleep, rapid eye movement. It is crucial, REM sleep, for your mental function. So it's consolidation of your memories as well as getting ready for mental performance and cognition. So really important, make sure you get it. If it's getting interfered with marijuana, I suggest probably stopping it. It happened to me a couple times that my peripheral vision disappeared. It passed in a couple of hours. What could that be?
I don't see much of nothing. As a matter of fact, I can't even see you, sir.
So temporary peripheral vision loss could be attributed to, most common would be like a migraine with an aura. You could be having, you know, abnormalities relating to like retinal detachments, but you definitely need to get that checked out to make sure you don't have a retinal detachment because that needs to be fixed. And then could there be a weird symptom relating to a brain mass or swelling or stroke? Potentially. So if you have any abnormalities relating to your vision, I would definitely get it checked out by a healthcare provider. What is foreskin restoration? I've heard it's a thing.
Hold it. This is getting confusing.
First off, what's foreskin? Foreskin is the skin that covers over the head of your penis, aka the glans penis. And people get circumcisions and have it removed. So this restoration is literally restoring the foreskin. So taking the foreskin that is still there, the remnants, and stretching it by different means, either by exercise or surgery, to then have foreskin for the sensitivity aspects, maybe aesthetic aspects, or other personal reasons. So it is a thing, it's not very common, but it is out there. I've seen a debate on whether or not to smear egg white on minor burns. What are your doctor thoughts?
Egg.
To not do it, please. So smearing egg whites on burns and these type of injuries is not recommended. It increases the risk of infection, okay? Literally, you have first degree, second degree, and third degree burn. Those are the most common burns that you're dealing with. And what we end up seeing is people coming into the emergency department with like dried up egg whites on their burns. We have to wash that off. That's painful. We have to keep it clean. So if the skin is still intact, it's just pain management and making sure the tissue stays moist. If the skin is then opened, this needs to have protection to it, a type of ointments on it, and get it seen by a healthcare provider. Are clipping your fingernails and toenails with the same nail clippers cross-contamination? So, good question. I guess the answer would lie in the fact of, do you have something to cross-contaminate with? Meaning, is one of your fingernails covered with an infection or a fungus? Then it would be potentially spread to others. But again, if you really want to be clean about it, after each nail, you can wipe down the nail clipper with alcohol wipes. But again, using a fingernail cutter with a toenail cutter, as long as there's no obvious sign of infection, you're not going to cross-contaminate. Number 12, what do tattoos do to the skin? Could it cause cancer or other diseases? Because it's sort of like a foreign body seeping into your skin. So in general, tattoos are or have been known to be relatively safe. The basic things you always worry about is obviously infection. But we're talking about the ink here. They have started to find that the ink actually does seep into our cells. They've also shown recent studies relating to the fact that it causes a type of inflammation within our body, requiring our machinery to keep working. So if you are contemplating having a tattoo, it is your own personal decision, just something to be aware of. Why are some people so horny and why am I not at all?
Do I make you horny, baby?
Sex drive varies immensely from individual to individual, and it's related to things like hormones, obviously, your brain function or your psychological state, and your current health status. So you could be doing different activities or living a lifestyle that reduces your hormone levels. You could be too busy with your life to where you just don't have a desire. You could be having poor blood flow to different parts of your body. So it's multifactorial, and if you are having issues, you need to talk to your healthcare provider to start investigating where this could be coming from and how can you address it. Hi, Dr. ER, how does a regional anesthesia affect our circadian rhythm?
He's asleep. I almost feel guilty about charging for the anesthesia. Almost.
So regional anesthesia shouldn't typically affect your circadian rhythm, aka your sleep cycle. Regional anesthesia is anesthetizing, numbing an area of your body. But, you know, it is not the same as if you're having general anesthesia, which affects your whole system, that would potentially affect your circadian rhythm. But even then, we use conscious sedation in the emergency department quite often, and the medications are fast acting. They're fast on and they're fast off. So it typically should not affect your sleep patterns. So if you are actually an individual who is struggling with sleep, you may want to try a supplement out there, and I've made one specifically to help with sleep. And this is called Do Not Disturb by my company, Life Happens. It's got bioavailable magnesium, passion flower, and L-theanine in it to help aid in a restorative night's sleep. So check it out at lifehappens.com or on Amazon. What happens if someone has bloody poop? Can this be cancer? Bloody poop has multiple causes. Yes, it could be cancer, but there are a lot of other more common things that this could be. It could be simply a hemorrhoid. It could be a fissure. It could be something called diverticulosis. It could be an infection. So if you have blood in your stool and it's consistent, it needs to get checked out. Go to your doctor, have a quick exam. Let us take a look so we can examine it and make sure you're okay. Great questions from Discord. Thank you. Keep them coming. I am grateful that you guys provide me questions to be able to give you some education back and hopefully answer the questions that you're burning to know. And if you guys enjoyed this, definitely check out this playlist right here. Binge watch everything for me. And as always, please subscribe, turn your bell notifications on, and hit that like button for me. Thank you so much for watching, and stay healthy, my friends.